To the next interpellator, the Honorable Congresswoman Luis Toro. Please proceed.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I wish to manifest that the refusal of Her Excellency Vice President Sara Duterte to take her oath in today's hearing in the conduct of inquiry in aid of legislation is an affirmation of her stand, her position during the budget briefing of the OVP. And this representation wishes to manifest that when the resource speaker does not take her oath, then it follows that whatever statement she will provide, we call it, it could not hold any water. That being not under oath, the same cannot be used as an evidence in any inquiry, in any proceeding, Mr. Chair. In other words, her refusal to answer in the last budget briefing of the OVP is tantamount to her stand in today's inquiry of refusing to take her oath. That is for manifestation, Mr. Chair. And with that, Mr. Chair, I wish to remind the committee, our esteemed colleagues, and the Filipino people of the constitutional mandate that public office is a public trust. When there is a question, we're bound to answer. We're bound to explain. As a matter of fact, no less than the Philippine Constitution provides, we are accountable to the Filipino people at all times. We are now confronted by the issue on confidential fund. And I wish to emphasize, ang confidential fund po ay pera ng taong bayan. And we owe it to the people to explain kung paano ito ginastos, saan ito napunta, and to be specific, sinunod po ba natin ang joint circular regulating the use of confidential fund. Mr. Chair, I wish to raise as well, to invoke as well, and remind our esteemed colleagues that pursuant to the separation of power, we, the Congress, is exercising the power to legislate. Under this power, we also have the power of the purse. We can amend, we can revise, we can approve, and we can disapprove the budget that was proposed to us by the executive. And I wish to remind as well that the best instrument which shows the power of the purse of the people is no less than the General Appropriations Bill, which is an embodiment of the allocation for the entire Philippine government, which is the result of the legislative process of the Congress. In other words, ang budget po ng ating bansa ay napapaloob din sa isang batas, saklaw ng kapangyarihan ng Kongreso, and that is the power to legislate. To be able to make sure that the power of the purse is properly exercised, we are granted as well by the oversight power. And that is to make sure that all our legislations, that includes the budget of the national government, the General Appropriations Act, are well complied with by our fellow public servants. And to make sure, and as a consequence of this oversight power, we have this inquiry in aid of legislation. So I just wish to remind the Filipino people, and that includes the OVP, ito po ay trabaho ng Kongreso. Busisiin ang budget. And not only that, to exercise the oversight power to make sure na yun pong ating mga nakaraang legislation, that includes the General Appropriations Act, ay nagamit ng tama ng mga ahensya ng gobyerno. I hope that the OVP will be enlightened to address the issues instead of attacking this institution, of politicizing and matters concerning politics, Mr. Chair. Third, Mr. Chair, we should be uniform in the application of our rules. If we are guided by the constitutional mandate that public office is a public trust, if we observe malfeasance, misfeasance, and nonfeasance in the LGUs, as a matter of fact, we have pending inquiry in aid of legislation concerning LGUs. Kung iniimbestigahan po natin ang Office of the Mayor, kung iniimbestigahan po natin ang Office of the Governor, by equality under the law, we should conduct an investigation as well to the Office of the Vice President. And I wish to thank the Honorable Valeriano for taking a stand before the plenary to initiate this inquiry in aid of legislation to address the observation not only of this representation, but of our fellow members of the Committee on Appropriations about the irregularities which we have seen already in the disbursement of fund. As a matter of fact, not only of the confidential fund, but even the regular allocation of the OVP. With that, Mr. Chair, may I proceed to my question for the COA?
Kanina yes. Po, but after your lengthy manifestation, you have already consumed 4 minutes.
Just one question, Mr. Chair. Just one question.
Yes, the Honorable Martuleta.
May I offer a counter manifestation, Mr. Chair?
Later po, 1 minute na lang po siya and then
kasi
I will
record. Nakalimutan yung continuity ng inflow ng discussion. I'd like to ask only, Mr. Chair, by way of manifestation, is there anybody who is questioning the power of the force of Congress? Is there anybody who is questioning the legislative function and oversight function of Congress? Is there? Because if there is none, then we are not supposed to overextend the discussion or any manifestation, because nobody is questioning that. And I think nobody could question that. Even the privileged speech of the Honorable Valeriano, I think the proper question there, the proper title is not asserting the power of the purse. We should not assert it because that power is inherent in us. Asserting or not asserting that power is of no moment. Yun po ay birthright. Yun po is inherent right of Congress. And let me make a record. The office of the Vice President, to my mind, did not undermine the power of the force. When she personally came in the first hearing and presented herself, including the budget, by way of a PowerPoint presentation, she made a presentation, Mr. Chair. And after that, she made a categorical statement that she said, Madam Chair, I forgo my opportunity to defend the budget of the Office of the President by way of question and answer, and instead I leave it to the discretion of the House of Representatives on their decision to decide on the proposal as presented. This is a very respectful answer, Mr. Chair. I did not find any offensive remark in that particular statement. She gave the entire House of Representatives the entire discretion, the entire right to decide on the proposal she presented before us. Why would we blame her for saying that she disrespected Congress? No, sir. I think it was triggered by the fact that questions were asked in relation to the confidential and intelligence funds. To my mind, Mr. Chair, these particular funds were subjected to a notice of disallowance. But the notice of disallowance, by its nature, by its very nature, Mr. Chair, is contestable. It is appealable. It is yet to be explained And initially, as explained by the representative of COA, the notice of disallowance suffered by way of supporting documents, by way of non-compliance with certain requisites. What if the Vice President is able to provide all the supporting documents? What if finally she is able to come up with the requisites required in order for you to consider that all these funds are eventually are allowable and they are not disallowed? And chances are she may be able to do that. Hindi po final judgment ang notice of disallowance. As a matter of fact, based on COA's own representation the other day, the Vice President received the notice of disallowance only on August 24, 2024, which means, Mr. Chair, the Vice President has 6 months within which to reply and make an answer. That is correct, Madam COA. So, 6 months is up to February 2025. We should give her all the allowance. We should give her the time. Because 6 months is 6 months. So why are we rushing to make a judgment? As a matter of fact, as I have already initiated earlier, Mr. Chair, when you said that anything we can discuss in this committee, provided it is of public interest, and you said that intelligence funds and confidential funds are public interest. But I said, because of our own rules, we should make a prior and preliminary determination that is directly and principally connected to malfeasance, misfeasance, or nonfeasance. We have not made that determination. How can we now begin questioning whether or not the intelligence funds covered by an initial notice of disallowance is already directly and principally connected with nonfeasance, or misfeasance, or malfeasance? Madam COA, how many agencies of government today are subjected to notice of disallowance? Do you have a number? How many agencies today?
With all due respect to the order,
that is a question I will leave, and I will terminate my manifestation, Madam.
Yes, but I will. I would like to respond.
This is still my time.
Yes, but I would like to respond to your manifestation, Congressman Marcoleta.
Parliamentary inquiry, Mr. Chair. Parliamentary inquiry.
What is the parliamentary inquiry of the
Honorable? I would like to ask the Honorable Marcoleta, is he rebuking this committee?
What is the question, Mr. Chair?
Are you rebuking this committee?
Why am I supposed to rebuke the committee? I am
you
not.
You have been saying things for a while.
What?
You have been rebuking this committee. We're not blaming the Vice President on this.
I asked the question.
The right to suspend. 1 minute suspension is the chair.
Book to suspend.